Okay, so in this video, I'm gonna show you how to make snow in Paint.net. And if you have watched my other Paint.net tutorial, where I go through some edits you can do, I showed how to make some particles, and this is gonna be quite similar, except for a thing I'll do at the end. So, how to make snow. So here we have a little test image here. First, you want to add a new layer, so just go down here and add new layer. And since it's snow, you want to pick white, so white. And we want to pick the paintbrush. The brush width probably... we'll start with 45. You want to vary the size of the dots we're gonna make. So we're gonna make some dots, and how we're gonna do that is simply just left-clicking here and there, just put them in random spots. I'm gonna make sure these doesn't go over the character. I'm not gonna put it here. We're gonna do that later. So I'm gonna put some around her, so it looks like the particles are kind of like behind her, I guess. And I'm gonna vary the size. I'm gonna decrease it, do some smaller particles, also some slightly bigger particles. Try to make it as natural as possible, which I'm not saying I'm very good at it, but I'm trying at least. Okay, so we have some random dots here and there now. So what we're gonna do now is go to effects, blurs, and Gaussian blur, and now just blur them a tiny bit, kind of like that. So now we go to effects and blurs again, and now motion blur. To make it look a bit more like snow, we're gonna add some motion blur to help with that. So I'm gonna angle it kind of like that, and then increase the distance kind of like that. Okay, and then I'm gonna go to properties down here and decrease the opacity a little bit. Okay, and now if we zoom out, looks actually kind of good. But we're gonna make another layer of snow, and how we're gonna do that is add a new layer. And these snow particles are gonna be a lot bigger, because I want them to be in front of the character here, so I want them a lot bigger. Now do the same, but, well, bigger. Kind of like that. And now do the same thing again. Go to effects, blurs, Gaussian blur. Blur them a little bit. Actually, you probably want to blur these a bit more, since they're supposed to be out of focus a little bit. And then blurs, motion blur, and do the same again. Maybe you want to angle them a different angle, I don't know. I'm gonna do that. Okay. And then again, properties, and decrease opacity. Like that. So now you have snow particles. And if you wanna go even further, you can do what I've done a few times. Photograph your own snow and put it on like the bean and stuff. So I'm gonna show you how I do that. Okay, so now I'm gonna get some snow here. Okay, I'm gonna put this here. For now, I'm gonna take this beanie and like cover it with snow. That's a bit better. So now I'm basically gonna take photos of this and use it in the poster, kind of like this. All right, that's not snow.
And also, if you don't have snow at home, just screenshot this video. I don't mind. Okay, so now I have a few photos here. I turned up the ISO way too high, but I didn't wanna bring out my tripod or something. I'm probably gonna go with this one, probably. What I'm gonna do to get these snowflakes how I want them, I'm gonna increase the contrast. So, adjustments, brightness and contrast. Up the brightness a lot, and then the contrast, like that. Then I'm gonna cut out only what I want, so I'm gonna cut out this. Then I'm gonna hit Ctrl C, a new layer, Ctrl V. So I'm gonna hide the original one, and so I'm gonna do brightness and contrast again, kind of like that. Copy this, and then we go here. So just go to properties, and blend mode screen. But we're not done yet. It looks kind of weird, but we're not done yet. I'll just put it here, and then deselect effects, blurs, Gaussian blur, and then just blur it a little bit. It's quite dim, you can't really see it, so I'm gonna do a quick fix and duplicate the layer. And then merge them. Like that. So, there you have it. And if you wanna go even further, I would suggest making the image a bit more blue, because when it's snowing, it's probably quite cold. So you want to add a new layer and pick your blue, pick the paint bucket tool, and just left click on the image. So now I have only blue, and then go to properties and set the blend mode to overlay, and then tempering it down. So now it looks much colder because the colors are a bit blue. You can tweak the blue tone if you want to, but I'm gonna, well, leave it as it is, like that. So that's how to add snow in paint.net. And if you're lazy, you could have just used an overlay on Google, but I wanted to show how to make your own snow. Of course, you don't have to use Splatoon SFM. This is just to show, well, how to add snow. It doesn't matter what you're using it on. You can use it on real life photos or some other 3D art or 2D art. It doesn't matter. It's just this part that's important. So that's it for the video. So thanks so much for watching, and bye!